Thank you, Jaliet Namawaya. Now, the misconception that alcohol cleanses the body of coronavirus has infiltrated Bokedia. Experts have rubbished these claims, saying that we should all follow the SOPs and visit healthcare if you have symptoms of coronavirus. They're also worried that it is such attitudes that are making the fight against COVID-19 immensely difficult. Take a look.
As they continue to assess the impact of COVID-19 in the eastern part of the country, members of parliament on the select COVID-19 committee this week held a meeting with the Bokedia District COVID-19 Task Force at the district headquarters. During the meeting, RDC Geoffrey Okiswa reported that people in the area have resorted to taking alcohol, claiming it washes the body of the COVID virus. He said the culprits, fearing arrest, gather in the bushes to drink.
We do minimal enforcement because there are some people who are still very stubborn. Some people misunderstood alcohol for sanitization, and when you go deep in the villages, they still insist that when they drink a lot of local brew and also local waraj, it helps to sanitize, and we're getting difficulties in that. They even go and hide in the bush and do the drinking.
Ali Kakoza, the district police commander, said even with a series of operations and scores of arrests by the police, people have remained defiant about drinking alcohol.
To take your waraji, buy it, go home, take it, but not in a group. Like they have their local way of drinking ajono here. It's called ajono in Uganda, we call it Marwa. They sit in a group. When they sit in a group, people come from different areas, for example, Mbale, Soroti, and other related nearby areas. They sit in one group. We don't know whether some are positive or negative. So they can contact from there, and at the end of the day, you know, some people get what? They COVID, the virus. So we discourage that in Tesoya, especially in Kedia. As a VPC, I don't allow that, and I already fight against it. Though I am being challenged by saying that it's their culture, but I have to because of the COVID situation.
In her report, Marion Okwap, the community development officer, said the lockdown and COVID stigma is the beginning to take a toll on mental health.
Fear of the unknown. I would say he was almost afraid because he lost one of his uncles who happened to have died of coronavirus. So he couldn't take it, and he gave up his life, and that was it. We've also had cases where people, after getting information that they've been diagnosed with coronavirus, go berserk. They run mad.
The district's chief administrative officer, Joseph Mukasa, also complained that teachers in the district have deliberately refused to take the COVID jab.
They are still having a challenge with the teachers. Some of them, in fact, many of them, did not turn up. And the challenge we have here is, like, as much as it was said that those essential workers should be the prioritized, it was left optional. You may come, you may not come. So what's going to happen, in case schools open and some teachers never went for the jab?
The RDC warned that teachers who fail to take the jab shall not be allowed to interact with students when classes resume.
We have required the district education officer to take full record of the teachers that have not yet got the jab or the vaccination, in short, against COVID. But also we are giving conditions that has been recited and set by the National COVID-19 Task Force, that those that have not yet got the jab or who are just deliberately refusing to be vaccinated shall not be allowed to interact with the children or the students.
The legislators also visited Bokedia Health Center 4, where they discovered that national medical stores had only delivered 15 small tins of sanitizer and 15 pieces of masks to over 80 health workers in the facility. Dr. Patrick Mutono called for an overhaul of NMS, saying the body's incompetence is alarming.
We are going to talk to Minister of Finance so that maybe they don't know. They think maybe NMS is delivering enough supply, but it is not. Our health units need a lot, 3-4 times of what they are bringing for the control of the pandemic. So that is an issue. It just can't be. If it was one health unit, maybe. It just can't be all the health units. There is a systemic problem.